Good afternoon, sir. Myself Vidyashree, and my question is like, even people who are vegetarians, sometimes if they have any health issues, so doctors will prescribe them to eat meals, some fishes or eggs. Why is it so? They know, even doctors, they will know that vegetarian foods and leaves and all, they will be healthy, even though they will prescribe meals, something, meat.
Yes, like basically fish, like, you'll get that cod liver oil supplements they would give. So, okay, I'll answer on that. Firstly, as I told you guys in the speech, regarding protein, I already gone over that. You can get all the protein you need from plant-based sources. There is no necessity for the Homo sapiens species to consume from animal-based food to meet its protein requirements. That is simply not there. Now, regards to fish, I will have to comment on that because doctors do sometimes prescribe cod liver oil supplements to those who are omega-3 deficient. Yes. And not to mention those who have heart problems are also given omega-3 supplements because that thins the blood.
Yes.
It makes the blood so that it flows better in the vascular areas. So about that, you see, omega-3 is basically the long chain EPA and DHA omega-3 fatty acids. Now, we do have, there's one source of omega-3 that's occurring naturally on Earth, and that is from algae. You see, fish themselves eat algae. A fish does not actually produce omega-3.
Yes,
fish eats algae that has omega-3, and they get omega-3, then we eat the fish. Now, there is algae-based omega-3 supplements in the market, and people can consume them if they want to. But I don't recommend that, neither do I take omega-3 supplements. I take something known as flaxseed or chia seeds. Now, these things contain something known as ALA, alpha-linoleic acid, which is the precursor to the long-chain EPA and DHA. When you consume, say, a tablespoon, it's important here, you have to ground up these seeds because the moment you eat them raw, they just come out as such. Your body cannot extract the nutrients. But when you grind them and eat them in a powdered form, add them to a smoothie, add them to oatmeal and eat them, your body now converts this alpha-linoleic acid, it has this inbuilt mechanism, into EPA and DHA. Therefore, without consuming fish, you can get your omega-3. Now, if you go to a doctor, I'm not a doctor, I have not studied for that, so I have no right to overrule a doctor's authority. But let's just say if I were in a position where a doctor told me, hey, Arvind, you have to take omega-3 supplements from fish, I'd be like, doctor, can I please take a DHA supplement instead? It's literally the exact same thing. If he says, okay, great. If he says, no, okay, doctor, can I please take 2 tablespoons of flaxseed to bump up my levels and make sure I catch on? Another thing to note now is that there are another fatty acid known as omega-6 fatty acids. Now, this is found in abundance in all the junk food and nonsense that we eat. So it's said that your omega-3 levels to omega-6 ratio should be like 3 times of omega-3 and only 1/3 of omega-6 is supposed to eat to be healthy. We are eating in the exact opposite, most human beings. So from a medical perspective, you could consult with a physician or nutritionist. You can take flax seeds, chia seeds, walnuts, hemp seeds. All these 4 foods are found on land. They are not, well, walnuts are a bit expensive, but cheap. Flax seed is so cheap. You can get that. Take a tablespoon of 2 of ground flax seed every day. You will get all the omega-3 your body needs. You will be fine and happy. The fish also will be fine and happy. That's my answer. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.